Half a day, I'm Tori Youngblood. This is what's making news in the Marianas.
Gas lines stretching for close to a mile on Middle Road as residents try to maintain the essentials in the days after Sudalore's destruction. Driving on Middle Road was mirrored by cars at a standstill waiting online for gasoline. Yesterday, we learned gasoline was only reserved for emergency vehicles.
We're trying because we don't have gas.
When we found Raquel back in the line, she had been waiting for 4 hours. She got there around 6:30 in the morning. At first light, too, was in a similar situation. She woke up and thought, I need gas.
There's not much I can do. I'm stuck. I'm almost gasless.
Shell was also inundated at the actual gas pumps with lines of gas cans waiting to be filled up. Around 1,500 passengers are stranded in Saipan after their flights were canceled. The Commonwealth Ports Authority says night flights are not happening for safety purposes. The Commonwealth Ports Authority has lifted flight restrictions in daytime. CPA Executive Director Marianne Luzama says airlines began flying in and out around 2 p.m. yesterday.
By tomorrow, because we're requiring the jets, the bigger aircrafts from the airlines to start submitting their flight schedules, just a courtesy to make sure that nothing goes discombobulated out there. So we still require the schedule.
Lazama says all flights are operating and the aircraft control tower is working to give the airport its eyes and ears. Typhoon Sudalore has left many people without water and power. Officials say there is still no timeline for repairs. Special Assistant of Homeland Security Marvin Semin says recovery efforts are ongoing. He says law enforcement is working with CUC to assess damages. Over 200 power poles on the island are down, but it is unclear when power will be restored. Semin says people need to stay off the roads to avoid accidents.
The biggest thing right now is to try and get the community to help us by limiting their activities out there. We're not able to move the rigs that we have from CUC, the firefighting and so forth. Because of all of those. We got so much cars out there and we've been getting a lot of reports that could have been avoided.
Semin says the Federal Emergency Management Agency arrived yesterday. They are working with local officials to improve the water shortage, but residents are urged to limit their water use to only essential household needs.
And for more news, log on to KSPN2.com.